From Banksy to Daft Punk, there's nothing quite like anonymity to create intrigue around your art. Now, following in their mysterious footsteps, the artist known as Rhed. Not that Rhed.
That's more like it.
Yeah, not that Rhed either. The 90s called, they want their references back. This Rhed has been scoring some serious buzz on the British art scene, drawing comparisons to the likes of Basquiat and even Picasso.
One of our top emerging artists.
The young art student mysteriously described as having a diverse and unconventional cultural background.
Paintings like Stan are of Rhed's artist friends and musicians.
Fetching up to $45,000 each, Rhed's works have been championed by the wealthy art elite and even celebs like Guy Ritchie and Madonna. Talk about hype! But there's a twist.
I am your father.
And mother, because it turns out Rhed is actually Madonna and Guy Ritchie's 21-year-old son, Rocco. The artist formerly known as Rhed, anonymous no more after being dramatically unmasked by the tabloids. So is his stuff really worth the hype?
Well, David Hume is the director of Banksy Hume Fine Art Consultants, and he joins us now. So, David, on a scale from Picasso right down to finger painting, where does Rocco's art sit?
Well, look, Madonna and Guy Ritchie offer up a pretty spectacular gene pool, so you'd kind of expect some pretty spectacular thing. But I really would put this down as fairly first-year art student kind of art, I would say.
Which is... Yeah. So on that basis, David, I'm thinking you probably wouldn't pay 45 grand for a Rhed original?
No, I wouldn't. I certainly wouldn't be recommending a purchase to one of my clients. I find that this is probably more a three-figure art than four figures. It's 45 grand.
See, I'm in two minds about this, right? Because part of me thinks that it's a bit sneaky of Madonna and Guy Ritchie to kind of, like, pump up his work without disclosing that they're related to him. But on the other hand, I feel like I do want to give him some props for, you know, at least trying not to cash in on the family name. He did try and go incognito there for a bit. What do you reckon?
Well, I think that's possibly true. I don't know whether the gallery would be saying that. I think they probably would use the Madonna name. I think maybe secretly kind of, and you know who... his mother is.
Who do you find most impressive in the celebrity art world?
Well, I would say Bob Dylan, actually. He's one of the best celebrity painters. Really remarkable work. Prince Charles, as an exceptional watercolourist, not that you can ever buy his watercolours, he doesn't sell them, you know, one of the greatest historical figures who painted would have to be Winston Churchill. He painted remarkable landscapes.
Do you think they'd probably get more than three figures if they sold their work?
Well, yes, famously last year. His paintings have gone up and up over the years, and famously last year, Christie's sold a painting by Winston Churchill, regarded as his best work ever, a Moroccan scene, which was given to Franklin D. Roosevelt. It's getting better and better, isn't it? During World War II. And that sold for over £8 million, which is about $15.5 million.
I mean, that's pretty good.
Now, David, I'm not sure if you're aware of this, but there's a new anonymous artist making waves around Australia, and we've actually got some examples of his art here. As you can see, this particular artwork is called The Truth. We don't know who's responsible for this, but can we get your thoughts?
I love that. I love that. And that's definitely four figures. Definitely four figures. I don't know what other
figures. Yes, I mean, I'm sure the artist will be very pleased.
I think four figures is actually the check that you're about to send to David, is the truth of it. David, thanks so much. We appreciate your candour this evening.
Thank you. Very enjoyable. Thank you. Good evening.